Hi everyone, in this video we'll learn what makes a list accessible and how they impact screen reader users by hearing what an accessible and inaccessible list sound like with a screen reader. To learn more about accessible lists, check out our resource below. Let's get started. Lists help us organize web content and can even make it easier to read for visual and screen reader users as long as they are made accessible. In order for lists to be accessible, it needs to be made with the correct HTML list elements. For example, if it's a numbered list, it would need an ordered list tag and a list item tag for each item in the list. Visually, this ends up looking like a numbered list. An accessible list with the correct HTML will announce to the screen reader user how many items are in the list. The screen reader user can even choose to skip the entire list instead of listening to each item, which can be really helpful in long or verbose lists. Let's hear what an accessible list sounds like. I'm using Mac's VoiceOver screen reader.
Heading level 3, ingredients. Your content list 10 items, bullet. 1 cup all-purpose flour, group, bullet. 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, group, bullet. 1, heading level 3, instructions. Your current content list 10 items, bullet. 1 cup all-purpose flour, group, in content list. 10 items, bullet. Bullet. 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, bullet. 1/2 teaspoon salt, out of content list 10 items, content list. Heading level 3, instructions.
Notice how the screen reader announced that there were 10 items. This gives the user a heads up about how long the list is. I was also able to skip the entire list without listening to each item. This is extremely helpful, especially with long lists like this one, because a screen reader user can more easily navigate through the content. Let's hear what an inaccessible list that is made without the correct HTML list elements sounds like.
Heading level 3, instructions. 1. Gather and measure out all your ingredients. 2. Whisk together the flour and baking soda, set aside. 3. Combine the butter with both sugars, beat on medium speed until light and fluffy. 4. Add the salt, vanilla, and eggs. 5. Add flour mixture. 6. Stir in the oats and chocolate. 7. Chill dough for 1 hour to overnight. 8. Preheat the oven to 307. 9. Drop heaping tablespoon size ball.
Because this list didn't have HTML list elements, the screen reader didn't announce how many list items there were, and I had to go through every single list item. I couldn't skip the list. When lists are made with the right HTML list elements, everyone can easily navigate them.